Hi, the topic of this tutorial is going to be ZSH. There was a question on our forum, said, okay, can you make a tutorial about ZSH? Now I'm totally a beginner in ZSH, but I can teach you some things already. All right, first off, this is our system. Am I now on ZSH? You can always ask an interesting word to remember, env. What are your environment variables? So if you open it up, it's even bigger, longer than we show you on the screen, even more up. There you are. That's the very, very beginning. In here is what your shell is. You don't need to go and look for it. You say just echo me shell. Tell me what's in that drawer. It's a kind of variable. So bin bash, okay, we like bin bash. Bin bash is cool. We have a file where everything is inside it. So that's the bash file, bash rc file. And we have a lot of aliases created. I show you this because I'll know in the next bit that all these aliases are gone. So if you want the aliases, we have to copy paste them over. So ZSH is a different kind of shell. We can use ZSH, and I do not have the time, or have not made the time yet to explore all the possibilities, but it's enormous. So I point you in direction of the internet. Go check it out. What do I know? We know that we have, for instance, the possibility in Arch Merge, AMD i3. We have this little program that's called 310 ZSH Software Themes version 1. So we have an application and a way to install it. And the only thing it does is go get this thing and run. What is this thing? That's this one, ZSH install ZSH. Okay. It's going to suit yaourt minus s ZSH. That's what it's going to do. That's this line here. So it's going to install ZSH. This package is also going to install ZSH completions. So to press tab and to get the completion of what you're typing, it's going to get, and that's the most interesting part for me as a designer, lover of a nice, sexy terminal. That's all my ZSH. It's coming from Robbie Russell. And what I do, and that's not what everybody likes, what I do is tell that the theme of Robbie Russell should be changed into random. I want to, each time I open up my Control Alt T, my terminal, each time I want to see another theme, be surprised by the theme. It does give sometimes errors because in these themes, these people point to programs or applications I do not have, and then you say application does not exist. But that's, you have to look over that. Then you have the syntax highlighting. It's more educational kind of thing. And command not found will suggest an command that's better. And that's it. So for me, it's a package. It's not just ZSH. I really want, for instance, this one together with it. Oh my ZSH, and without completion, it would be hell. I mean, you have to really type every letter. So that's the package I will for application that I will run. You can run it separately, or you can go to my GitHub. So github.com arch merge linux slash amd dash i3, and probably on budgie as well. Let's take a look if I've done that. It's just checking if I did my work there. Otherwise, I'll put it there later on. So ZSH is there. That's no surprise, but I have it. I have it. It's 310 ZH. Okay. So that's okay. You can start it from here. You can start it from there. It doesn't really matter as long as the applications run. So 310 is it called? And there we go. He wants to know my password, obviously. So, all right. Yeah, sorry. So I have already installed. This is my main system. So just run it. It takes a little bit longer on your side, but at the end, it will just install. And then this is the main thing you should remember. You are on bash and you want to change. and I cannot change it for you. I don't know your name. No? So sudo change shell Eric minus s bin zsh. That's it. Changing shell for Eric. Shell is changed. Is it changed in here already? No. So what you need to do now is reboot. And if you reboot, then you will see that the shell is changed to zsh. And you'll see that when you press Ctrl Alt T, you'll get another look. I am on the real thing. I'm not on a VMware machine. So I'm going to cut the video in two. And after rebooting, you can follow the other tutorial. All right.